if you want to have a career as a musician and you want to, you know, not have to have a day job and focus on music and make music your life, you absolutely have to break into the United States.
Texas, yes, Austin, Texas, the live music capital of the world. When you come here, play your heart out like it's your last time.
They have been robbed. Their van was broken into last night.
This is a very intimidating place to play a show.
It's a matter of going at it like they did in the beginning in Canada and earning every fan.
The 2011 Juno Award for New Group of the Year goes to...
So good. A great documentary that's airing on CBC. You have an opportunity to watch it if you're a fan of Said the Whale or if you just love music and road trips.
Oh,
you will love this documentary. Brent Hodge joining us, director, producer, Winning America, and Ben Worchester, singer, guitarist for Said the Whale. Worcester, was that good?
That was good. That's as good as it gets.
Was it Grant Lawrence good or just good?
Well, that's a tough, you know, that's a bar you don't want to raise too
high. Grant Lawrence gets your name right every time.
Every time. On the button.
We wore the Radio 3 shirts. We were going to wear full hockey gear.
Oh. It's like, you know, Brent, tell us about this. Tell us about the documentary first and the whole idea and how it sort of came to be.
Sure. I got approached by John Siddle and Sheila Peacock, and they're CBC producers. And they approached me because I work at Radio 3, and they said, you know, would you like to do a video? We were thinking of maybe a tour diary kind of style video following a band down to South by Southwest. It was our little scheme of getting down to Texas and having fun.
Yeah, that's right. How do we do this?
Yeah. But Thomas Bucking and myself filmed it, and we've worked together a lot, and we picked Said the Whale, and we said, why don't we go out in Vancouver on the tugboat and follow Ben around for a day and see what kind of guys they are,
guys and girl band.
Yeah, and we just knew right away.
And Ben, for those who don't know, what is South by Southwest?
It is the biggest gong show you'll ever attend. It's the most expensive festival to attend, so you have to be a band and play it in order to go. And it's one.
And it can lead to tons of opportunities for a band. So give us the brief story. What kind of opportunities can be opened up for a band, say, like Said the Whale?
Just being there was an opportunity. You know, not everybody gets to play. It's pretty tough to get in. We've been trying for a few years, and finally we had our chance. We had five shows, and one of them was really awesome. And
which for most bands, that's exactly the sentiment. That's the perfect success story of South by Southwest.
Yeah, one of the shows
we had five
awesome.
Gigs, and one of them was off the hook.
Yeah, and I just wish we could have, you know, one amazing show next time, and then just enjoy the festival for 4 days. But a lot of running around and getting organized and doing interviews.
Ben, you guys were really open for Brent and for the crew and everything about where you were in your career, and you guys have had great success in Canada. Just as you were going through this, you were nominated and went on to win a Juno. But you know, you guys have things that you want to accomplish and things that you want to do, and you were really open about that, which I thought was really interesting.
We do, and we're getting there one step at a time.
How hard work, I mean, people don't really appreciate it until you see something like this. When it comes to being a successful band, how much of it is putting boots on the floor and just playing gigs?
So much of it. You know, we've been a band for just over 4 years, and we've been as far as Montreal. We call it as far as Montreal across Canada,
right.
At least 10 times.
So do I.
And the Newfies don't mind. That's fine.
Well, we've been as far as St. John's twice, and that's a big effort because it's a 9-hour ferry and a 12-hour drive, and it costs about $500 either way to get there with our tour van. So, been as far as St. John's, and totally worth it. I cannot wait to go back.
Yeah, no kidding.
But it's all hard work, and we're still working really
hard.
And
the love of the music too, Brent. And that was the big standout for me for the documentary, is that these guys love what they do. They will do anything to do it, including sleeping on the floor, the cramped confines of a van touring that far across Canada, which is not an easy thing to do. What was it like for you to follow this? And there you guys guys are, sleeping on the floor.
That right there is South By.
But how was this for you, Brent? Yeah. I mean, just to sort of tag along and be a fly on the wall a little.
Yeah, honestly, it was really interesting, too, because a lot of, when you see the doc, a lot of funny things happen in this. Spencer gets mustarded.
Mustarded. You'll mustarded. Have to define that, because if you don't know.
Please do not look up Urban Dictionary under mustarded. You don't know what you'll come up with.
I mean, their stuff also gets stolen, and you really get to see what kind of characters they are. I mean, even just Ben, when the mustard happens, the cops are there, and they say, I hope this doesn't ruin it for you. And Ben says, well, it could ruin this. It's a perfect day.
Yeah.
People are having fun. And that really shows a lot about these guys and what kind of band they are and how they're not going to give up.
But that was in the script.
Right, he cued me from the line as he went.
And Ben, where are things now for Said the Whale? Are you guys making a new album? What are you doing?
We're recording a new album, and I just couldn't be happier with how it's going. I get home, and I think about it, and my face hurts
from
smiling.
Beaming. You're beaming. Literally beaming about it.
It's like being the proudest father of the most beautiful children, and, you know, it's a really huge labor of love, and the whole band is putting so much into it, and I couldn't be happier. I only write the lyrics to half the song, so I get to be the biggest fan of the other half. And
right, you get to just listen to it, enjoy what everybody's done.
Yeah, and I'm the biggest fan in the world of Tyler's, you know, writing, so it's pretty awesome.
Brent, how much of an appreciation do you gain of how hard people have to, I mean, regardless whether it's Said the Whale or any other band, this is not an easy road to follow. I mean, it really has to come from passion, right?
Yeah, and, you know, working at Radio 3, I see a lot of bands coming through.
Yeah.
You know, and a lot of the time, it's what's the business plan for them?
Right.
You know, what are they going to do? And
Business plan?
What's the business plan? Yeah.
What is that?
But it's tough for Canadian bands. I mean, you play in Vancouver, you're going 12 hours to Edmonton, which is costing a lot of money, or Victoria, which is a lot of money too.
Yeah.
You play in the States, within a 5-hour radius of where you are, there's a university city, there's a big city, there's people that want to go out. So.
And tons of venues.
Yeah. So
the nice weather.
Yeah.
It's the American dream.
How important is that market for you guys? Because this is sort of a theme in the film, and I hate even using the term market, but I mean an audience, I guess, for the U.S., because there is a huge population there. It can make the difference between sort of eking out a living and you know, doing something you love and getting paid for.
It's exactly that. It's, you know, we love Canada. We'll never stop touring Canada. It's, you know, not that we don't care any less. It's that there's more people in California alone than in Canada.
Yeah.
So to be able to tour in the States, we could spend 6 weeks in just California and play new places all the time and build that market. And it's not just about the States, it's about the world. And the U.S. is just the biggest market and kind of the most important in our field.
Well, now, there's one really important question we would be remiss if we didn't ask. What the hell is bacon toast?
Oh, you guys. This is
Ben,
this is probably...
It's a bad time.
That's
what
bacon
toast is. This is probably both the best and the most horrifying hangover food I've ever seen in my entire life.
It?
Well, Tyler says it best. It's like French toast, only instead of egg, you're actually just soaking up bacon fat.
So you make bacon, you take all the grease,
and
you make toast.
You put the bread right on top of it, and you wait till the toast is crispy and soggy at the same time.
What time in the morning and how drunk do you have to be to think this is a good idea?
I don't remember.
Well, you get to relive it all the time. I can't see.
Look at that face. That is happiness, people.
He goes back for another, and here he goes back for a second.
You guys, thank you so much, and you'll get a chance to see the documentary, Winning America. It will be airing on CBC. Make sure that you check it out. And you guys love Radio 3 and Grant Lawrence.
We love Radio 3.
No, wait. SaidTheWhale.com is the website to find out more about the band. And, of course, we'd love to have you guys back when the album comes out.
Love to be back.
That would be tremendous.
And if you love the music as well, I got to say, Brent, you guys did such a good job at getting the music and the mix, and it just sounds so good.
Yeah, it was. Well, we had the right people to work with. So
Aww,
there you go.
Hug it out.
We're going to take a break.